Now to a story only on Denver 7, recreational dog sledding. It's a sport and an adventure you can try with your four-legged friends right here in Colorado. So I met up with some local dog mushers connected with the Rocky Mountain Sled Dog Club who took me out for a quick demo to learn more about it.
On a cool Colorado winter day.
We'll dress them up with their harnesses. Come on, Marion.
Mike Sullivan prepares his excited pups to go on an adventure out in the snow. Taking time to go over course conditions with his friend, Linda Cathy.
You can see there's a little drop.
Yeah.
And that's just a sunspot, I think.
And getting his dogs lined up and ready to go sledding.
So we're going to have these guys be our leaders today. Come on, Winston, you're going to be a rock star.
Mike has been mushing, yes, that's an official term, for more than 30 years, and says the skills a musher needs includes a soft voice, good balance, and should be physically fit.
4, 3, 2, 1, let's go!
There's that surge of power, and it reminds you of just being on a launching pad, and you're literally going into orbit. It's addictive. You know, I just can't get it out of my system.
A feeling Linda can relate to when she's gliding across the snow with her dogs leading the way.
It's more of a peaceful tranquility when you're going through the middle of nowhere by yourself with just the dogs. It's a kind of a zen moment.
Dog sledding requires at least 6 to 12 inches of packed snow.
Well, a lot of dogs can do it. Poodles, retrievers, all kinds of dogs can do mushing.
You can also use a dry land cart like this one that Linda uses so she can go sledding with her dogs all year round as long as the temps aren't too hot.
So what you would look for is a very high energy dog. Have been returned to the breeders because there's so much energy. They eat the house up because working dogs need a job to do.
This activity involves a lot of teamwork and communication, creating a special bond between the musher and their four-legged friends.
You can put a bunch of dogs in the truck and your sled or cart, and you can just go anywhere. And you get to explore different parts of the country with your dogs, and that's a lot of fun.
Curious about what it's like to go dog sledding, Mike let me ride along to get the full experience. Gliding across the snow as a passenger in a train of dogs leading me to some of Colorado's best trails. But like all good things, it must come to an end.
Everybody's looking really good.
It's time for us to return from our pioneer-like exploration.
Okay, bye-bye.
So Mike and Linda can take care of their dogs and give them a reward for working together.
Now they get treats
out on the course.